kidding me?
Here's a shot that I believe they score!
Now switches hands. He scores!
Oh my goodness!
Superior in skill, persistent with appeal, charisma mixed with attitude, I'm vicious on the field. I'm making history, stay filling up that trophy case. In case you don't understand the standards, I'm getting dialing zeros, commas, and promise that I'm
a champion. I'm a champion. Oh, you know I go hard. I never lose.
The league, the players, the fans, all of us have been waiting a long time for this. The playoffs are back, and the chase for the championship begins as the Halifax Thunderbirds take on the Toronto Rock in Hamilton. Rob Hellier, a bonus boost for the Toronto Rock. Some uncertainty as to whether he would dress, but is back after a four-game absence, trying to bolster the Toronto offense. Here's a look at what's ahead. Obviously the game in Hamilton with Toronto and Halifax, but plenty of other matchups to keep our eyes on through the weekend as we get you set for a all-Canadian battle. John Abbott and Pat Gregoire, we can hardly wait to get to the game, but it's so good we have to tee it up, Pat. This is a winner-take-all clash. We know there's a lot of pressure in both these teams, but Toronto gets an unexpected boost. They weren't prepared to have Rob Hellier back.
A little bit of a game-time decision, and anytime it's do or die, winner goes on. You want to have all your weapons. They get a great one in Rob Hellier, and Hellier is a guy that comes up in big performances as well.
And they might need him because Halifax has the edge in the season series as we look all the way back to December. Clark Peterson, a 7.96 of those goals leading into the overtime finish.
In this building, it was empty, but it was an electric game in overtime. Steph LeBlanc scoring a huge goal for Halifax to pick up their first win, or second in this series, I should say.
That was a game the Rock talked about as being a turning point in their season. They would get the last laugh, and in a big way, a dynamite night from Dan Craig to cap the season series. Two wins for the Thunderbirds, but a big closing effort from Toronto. Hard to pick a line between the two of these teams.
Well, the hotter team is certainly Toronto, but the history leaning towards Halifax, making this first round matchup that much sweeter, John.
Anything can happen in a one game winner take all. For more on the head-to-head, let's go to Ashley Docking.
Toronto and Halifax come into tonight as mirror images of each other. The Thunderbirds, once considered the class of the East, have stumbled into the postseason with a 3-6 record over the last 2 months. Toronto, on the other hand, has never looked better. They're riding a 5-game win streak, including a victory against the Buffalo Bandits last weekend. Micah Kersey told me that people can think they're the underdogs. That's fine. They've already beat Toronto twice, but none of that matters. It is one and done, and this is the time, as Dan Dawson and Scott Campbell elaborate on, where legends are made.
I think every player loves having that pressure. You're measured by player by what you do in big games, and you know, growing up, how many times have you scored that winning goal, game 7 in your driveway or in the backyard? This is your chance to prove it. And I tell all the young guys and guys that maybe have never been in this situation that every game's the same. There's just a lot more on the line tonight. That's the biggest difference between every game we play. Tonight means you win or you go home. It's that simple.
The nerves will always be there a little bit, which is good. I think you can kind of feed off it. Don't let it take over, but kind of use those nerves as like a positive energy. And you know, and just try to keep like the same day kind of routines going and everything else like that, so it makes it just feel like a regular game. But know that, like, you know, in the back of our heads, we know that, you know, hey, there's no tomorrow if we don't win, right?
A big-time veteran presence in this game, including Nick Rose. He's been fantastic for Toronto this year, and John and Pat, as you know, has a penchant for big saves in major moments.
Certainly does. Thank you, Ashley. Rose second in the league in wins in the regular season and running red hot with the rest of the Rock to finish the campaign. And it's up to Warren Hill to try and combat that tonight and refine some of his magic pad.
Well, there's no doubt that we haven't seen the Warren Hill that we were used to at the start of the season. But Nick Rose, looking at his numbers against Halifax, it kind of seems like the Thunderbirds have this guy's number.
Well, Warren Hill is going to be busy anytime you throw a team like the Toronto Rock at him. But how about one of the league's leading goal scorers in Tom Schreiber shooting missiles? He has been splendid. Everything the Rock needed this season, Pat, and he's certainly hoping that translates into the postseason.
He's a big-time player, and he's a guy that continues to elevate his game in big moments. We've talked about it all season. This guy is one of the game's most elite playmakers, and now he's become the best goal scorer in the league. Finished with the most goals in the entire NLL, and he is going to be the straw that stirs this offensive drink. They're going to go as far as Tom Schreiber takes them this season.
He has been, Tom, terrific. As you look at the numbers and the company, that says it all, right on top of the NLL goal leaders. Part of this fantastic matchup that we bring you, presented by Sports Interaction on TSN, can hardly wait. It starts for real, Halifax and Toronto, when we come back.
The NLL on TSN is brought to you in part by Alterna Savings. Alterna offers easy, more personal financial services and puts the good in banking. Visit alterna.ca to learn more. By fanatics.ca. The NLL's home for officially licensed everything. Visit fanatics.ca today. And by Guaranteed Rate. If you believe it, you can do it. Guaranteed Rate. Believe you will.
In the scene for the NLL playoffs, essentially a game seven, but it's game one. Halifax, the Thunderbirds, and the Toronto Rock. Warren Hill, as we look at the starting goalies presented by Guaranteed Rate, will try to rekindle some of that magic. Made 45 saves for a win against the Rock earlier this year. And Nick Rose, over 1,000 minutes in the cage this year for Toronto, and his game just continued to get better, peaking for the playoffs. Head-to-head matchup for the fourth time this season, first time in the postseason, and it's Withers versus Erlin on the faceoff. A battle we'll be keeping track of all game, Pat. It matters, the possessions, especially when these two teams can be oh so close on the floor.
We know a game of runs, that's what lacrosse is all about. You get the possession right here, it's a good way to start the game.
Keo hands it off. Thunderbirds and Ushi give up that early look.
We know how close this season series was, but the one edge that the Thunderbirds really had was in the face-offs with Jake Withers over TD Erlin.
Hell, you're back in the lineup for the Rock, as mentioned in the opening, after missing four games with an upper body injury. Welcome Sight and Schreiber. Dishes. Little spin around, but didn't quite go the way they wanted to. Here's Hossick sprinting up the floor. Stop, shoots, bouncer over top of the goal man by Nick Rose. Quick transition there, and yeah, tough to decide, but Rocket coming in as the hottest team, Pat. winning five straight and 11 of their last 13. Little spin cycle there. Rose denies it. And a fresh 30 for the Thunderbirds.
No Sean Evans in the lineup here tonight.
Robinson protecting, goes up top, and Rose holds his ground through plenty of traffic early. Shriver, some daylight. Shot clock, loose ball. That's normally right in the wheelhouse of the snow, and they can't even hear the whistles here. With a packed house in Hamilton. Shriver works his way back to the outside. Shoots from distance off the post. As that one whizzes to the left of Warren Hill.
Looks like we've got Scott Campbell. Oh, what a big hit there from Jake Withers on Nick Rose. He's fair game when he comes out of the crease.
Dan Craig. And now we've got action between the benches. In fact, that's an illegal line change because the Thunderbirds and Withers ends up in the Toronto bench.
And it's going to be Latrell Harris, as we'll see right here. Big hit on Nick Rose. He stands his ground, but let's go the other end as Brandon Robinson got upended there. Nick Rose has had to be sharp. Well,
2 minutes, illegal body check. Halifax Bradley, 2 minutes, illegal substitution. 5-on-5.
Mark Gardonia gonna talk to the captains there as they explain it. So it's an illegal substitution, but then also a penalty to Latrell Harris for knocking Jake Withers into his own teammate's bench. So we're gonna stay 5-on-5 here.
See the early aggressiveness to this bitter rivalry. Jameson trying to break free, does. Swings over, Fennell nearly picked that far side. Thunderbirds well aware of Toronto's slow starts at times, although no problem here for the Rock to get up the floor. Hill with a big stop on a good look from Rogers.
Jalen Rogers going back out the back door here tonight as Rob Hellier comes back into his offensive role, but that doesn't mean Jalen Rogers can't score goals. We know how deadly he is storming up the floor.
21 this year for Rogers in the regular season. Dynamic, multi-faceted player. Hellier goes for a run. Shriver swings over and Mance puts it on. Hill stops that with ease and starts the play ahead. Bell surveys, holds, shoots, and stopped by Rose, making it look easy at the other end.
Nick Rose certainly dialed early on. I mean, we talked about how good he has been this season. You got to assume, John, his name is going to be in that discussion for goaltender of the year.
Certainly think so. One shot! Shriver opens it up for the Rock! Sniper is Shriver, and Toronto leads 1-0.
If you're a coach and you see a player wind up from this spot on the floor, on the wrong side of the floor, you are having nightmares. But when it's Tom Shriver, this guy can shoot from anywhere as he takes the hard check from Colton Armstrong after he finishes his check, and it goes in the back of that to give the Toronto Rock an early 1-0 lead here in the Hammer.
11th career postseason goal, and again, I don't think it can be stated enough, 47 goals in the regular season for Shriver, who didn't play the entire season. That's in 16 games. Hellier back on the floor, picks up a helper as well, as does Burns. So there's the effect of having the savvy offensive touch of Rob Hellier as well.
And he's a guy that comes up at the big moments as well, John.
Craig, he'll try from distance.
Hellier averaging just under 4 points per game in the postseason. He was a huge part of that offense in their run to the championship back in 2015.
Robinson had the pick set, now lost it under pressure. Walker gonna storm back the other way. Ostrouser started it up. Trevor shoots and a stop by Hill. Good luck and save right there. And cue the extracurriculars. Yeah, this is, we're just getting started both time-wise and rivalry-wise as the pushback is real in the playoffs. Chopped free again, but no stick, doesn't matter. Free gets it up the floor anyhow, and Hill, another good save, reaching to his right.
Your Halifax Thunderbirds fan, you got to be happy with the way Warren Hill has looked early on here. A couple of big stops, looking a little more confident in between the pipes here for the T-Birds.
Nice exchange in tight. Doesn't form anything for the Rock. Yeah, that's not to be overlooked. Told earlier that Warren Hill wasn't 100% as he battled through the end of the year. And such a key component of that Thunderbirds team, as you mentioned, Pat. Fennell on the move, breaks free. Dishes off, Keogh takes a look down deep. Swing shot by Bushi right on, and Rose gets one leg down.
Would have loved Fennell to take that shot. He had an open look.
Rogers, power move, and a big save by Hill to shut down the Rock captain. Talk about a confident player. What a move by Rogers. Hellier had it knocked down. Dawson gets it back. Craig again to Dawson. 40-year-old put it right in the scoop there. Bell, he's going to take this all the way. Bell shoots. Stopped by Rose. Point blank.
Calm, cool, and collected is Nick Rose. Another big stop in transition. Unflappable.
Jubenville started the play ahead. Hellier has a man on the move. Swings it right back to Schreiber, however. Waiting for the footwork, but he's followed. Schreiber, nowhere to go. Sends it over. Heavy coverage here by Halifax. Another outside shot, but my goodness, Schreiber nearly worked magic again. And what a call on the crease crash from Manns.
A near perfect defensive shift by Halifax. You'll see with just maybe a couple of seconds left on the shot clock, goes off the shoulder of Hill. Instead, the clock's restarted, and it's Zach Manns who picks up the loose ball, takes it to the rack, little fake, dip, dunk, bang. In the back of the net, the Toronto Rock take a 2-0 lead.
That has to feel good for Manns. Victoria, BC native, his first ever playoff goal. We were talking about the Rocks' slow starts at times, sprinkled in and out through the season. Even in their last game of the regular season, had to come from behind to beat Buffalo. Not a slow start tonight, as they have a pair. Schreiber the first, and how about this look right into your living room from Zach Manns.
only charge for the home playoff games that happen right here at First Ontario Center. Visit TorontoRock.com or hit up the ticket info table at section 116. So tonight is a great opportunity for you to gear up for the rest of the playoffs. Since I'm getting a jersey, I'll tell you about the first time of the game. You get your jersey, white, blue, all the way, and we'll customize the back of it for you for free. We'll put your favorite player's name and number on, or your name and your number on. You can get that at section 115.
Rock in the lead, 2-0, as we bring you back to Hamilton. Also, because of the stops from that man.
Just so calm in his net, makes the big save on Tyson Bell, who knows how to play in the performance, and he's been so sharp early on.
For more on the adjustments of the Halifax Thunderbirds, let's go to Ashley Docking.
Yeah, guys, earlier this week, Micah Kersey was telling us that he knows that there's so much research and game film that goes on in the NLL, so goalies know what to expect from certain players. He encourages his guys to do something out of the ordinary. If they're used to an overhand high-low, maybe try something underhand early on in the game. But for Halifax, it's a matter of getting shots off, you guys. We've seen the Toronto defense cause a number of turnovers as Halifax has their turn with that here now.
Thank you, Ashley. Yep, have to do something significant to beat both of these men, but particularly Rose, the way he's been playing coming in.
Such a great point by Ashley. The transition game and special teams are going to be huge for Halifax if they want to find the back of the cage.
Rogers lost it at one end. Rock get it back at the other. Turn and burn up the floor. Look at the smoke. And what a goal! Oh, my goodness! Latrell Harris, are you human?
What a defensive stand. The slide from Mitch Disnew causes the turnover. And then Latrell Harris says, everyone all aboard the Trelly train as he takes flight. One hand on the stick, doesn't matter. Little twister right in between the wickets of Warren Hill. And John, I thought the roof was about to pop off here at First Ontario Center.
Struggled early in his career with a shoulder injury to Harris and persevered to have a career year in the regular season this year. Adds a little flair to the beginning of this one. 3-0 Rock. Thunderbirds have had their looks as well, but haven't been able to crack the case of Nick Rose to this point. Penalty coming up. Rose didn't make it to the bench, and it'll be the Rock that tests the power play first.
Tyson Bell, one of the many players that you will let. Ian Garrison on the floor with the call, the roughing on Tyson Bell. Tyson Bell, one of the many players on this Thunderbirds roster who have won a championship. He won the last one the NLL had back in 2019 with the Roughnecks.
Rock power play have been lethal on their home floor this year. 21 of their 43 goals scored right at home as Schreiber tried to go up top. Dawson, lots of time. Schreiber closed and off the post again. Second one he's hit, same post. Thunderbirds have 9 shorties this year. As the Rocks set it up on the man advantage, Rogers inside. Could make it work.
Shows you the confidence that Matt Sawyer and this coaching staff has in Jalen Rogers. Hellier back in the lineup, but 23 still on the floor.
Great point, Pat. He's become such a big part of the offense along the way. Here's Schreiber, breaks free, backhand, scoop right on, and Hill was ready for that magic. Thunderbirds stretching it out. Take some time off the clock here. Robinson distributes.
You mentioned those 9 shorthanded goals, second amongst all NLL teams. They're going to certainly go to the rack here.
Well, Jamison got the look he wanted from a sharp angle, albeit. And the Thunderbirds relinquish the possession there. Tail end of the power play for the Rock. Greg and Rogers. Rogers, a missile denied by Hill. Captain works it again for Toronto. Greg comes up top. Hellier. Penalty over. Bell comes out. Hellier can't shoot. Room taken away. Nine to shoot for Toronto. Dawson, nice move. Couldn't get to the inside cleanly, though. Now he's pushed right to the outside by Hossack. And boy, you're not getting free of that steel blanket. Toronto can't make it work on the power play, but Latrell Harris gives the Rock a 3-0 lead in the first. City of Hamilton is situated upon the traditional territories of the Erie, neutral, Huron-Wendat, Haudenosaunee, and the Mississaugas. It's covered by the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Belt Covenant to share and care for the resources around the Great Lakes. We further acknowledge that this land is covered by the Between the Lakes Purchase of 1792. Today, Hamilton, home to many Indigenous people from across Turtle Island. We recognize we must do more to learn about the rich history of this land so we can better understand our roles as residents, neighbors, partners, and caretakers. Some question as to whether Hamilton was going to get a home playoff game at the beginning to mid of this season. And unbelievably, as we mentioned off the top, Pat, it's been a tale of two different seasons for these two teams. Halifax started real hot. Thunderbirds were 8-1 as of March 5th, finished 2-7. And the Rock went 11-2 after losing to the Thunderbirds in overtime.
And you mentioned that off the top. That overtime loss was something that the Rock have noted as a turning point. They lost, but they felt that.
Schreiber scores! Second of the first quarter. And Toronto improves to 4-0.
See a little bit of a slow change, and Schreiber recognizes that not even his entire offense is on the floor, just four blue shirts, and they're all defenders. But Schreiber says, hey, that's fine. Set a little pick for me, free a little bit of his space. I'm just going to throw a little bit of a fader into the back net.
That's the kind of year it's been for Tom Schreiber. Gifted. Uber talented player, but the ball's been gold in his stick all season long. Hellier. Schreiber. Mans. Nice move. Chased up top by Tarasenko. Gets a little bit of a seam, but doubles back to Dawson. Two to shoot. Have to hurry, and that's still somewhat surprised Hill there. He was able to come across,
and that was almost off the leg pad of Hill. Luckily for Halifax, doesn't go off, so going to get a much-needed possession here on offense for the T-Birds.
Dawson Thede was hurt last time in Toronto. Big reappearance for him. The Thunderbirds, who picked him up in a trade with Panther City. Cree. Right up the middle. No chance there for Hill. As DeSue buries to give Toronto a 5-0 start.
And it looks like Aaron Bold's going to grab his stuff. I think Warren Hill's night is done for now. But the transition continues to boom for the Rock as Mitch DeSnew, coming off a career year in the regular season, is picking it back up in the postseason. An absolute cannon. A little flip from Cree, and the dynamic duo for the Toronto Rock put an exclamation point onto this start for the Rock. It's 5-0.
14 Rock shots, 5 Rock goals. Okay, now 15 shots credited. So one of the X factors in this game, Pat, was going to be the play of Warren Hill. Seemed like early on he had been able to refine some of that form that gave Halifax such a great start to the season. Jameson tries to go down low, but quickly it's the Rock opening up a 5-0 lead, and Mike Kersey decides a little time for change of strategy, change of momentum.
Yeah, let's be honest here. A lot of those goals, not Warren Hill's fault. Left
absolutely
pretty much hung out to dry at this point. This is more or less a spark, trying to get something going here for his Thunderbirds team.
Fennell buries, and the Thunderbirds have flight.
Well, I did say spark. Why not talk about the spark plug of this offense? That is Eric Fennell, a crasher, a banger, a great grinder. But this season, he has added some serious touch and finish. What an unbelievable shot. Just kisses the top left corner. Beats Nick Rose. And maybe that's the spark that the Thunderbirds offense needed.
Well, certainly a surprise to see Aaron Bold in net this early into the playoff game, and who knows where they go from here. You're right, not all on Hill by any means, but not the start Halifax would have wanted. Try and work their way back into the first quarter. Jubaville ahead, gets the pass, and he'll test Bold and goes down to make a good first save.
Let's not forget Aaron Bold, a multiple NLL champion, won the finals MVP back in 2016.
37-year-old, part of the veteran backbone. Emotional win against Vancouver this year to get to a 2-1 record, so that tells you how much they've used Warren Hill. Last time they were in Toronto, both goaltenders played. Hellier right into the chest of Bold. Armstrong just taking a hit, keep on ticking. Thunderbirds trying to find some late quarter results. That one skips wide. Rocker just going to slow this one down. Under a minute remaining in the first.
You don't hear that too often, do you, John? Toronto Rock going to slow things down. They like to play fast and furious.
Well, if you go back and look at that 5-0 goal, what does it say when two players, Cree and DeSnew, up for the defensive players of the year, combine to go offensively and force the goaltending change? Shot clock reset. That was the short pause in action. Campbell, the veteran.
Another guy that I would say his name is in the hat for Defender of the Year. Remarkable what we're seeing from him at 40 years old.
Keo up top. Fennell with the only goal for Halifax. Jamison to the side. No quick stick action there. Three carries up. Takes a look. Played away inadvertently by Jubinville. Thunderbirds may have one last dash here. They can hustle up the floor. And that'll do it for the first, as the Toronto Rock go on a string of five straight before Halifax, after a goaltender change, find their first. First quarter belongs to Toronto. Three great ones, no doubt, coming up when we return on TSN. Heating up in Hamilton, a blazing start for the Toronto Rock, up 5-1 against the Thunderbirds. More on the action on the floor. Let's go to Ashley Docking.
Thank you so much, guys. When owner Kurt Stiers was trying to come up for a name for the Halifax Thunderbirds, he wanted it to have some soul and some meaning, so he hired an outside marketing company to try and find the magic. What he got was underwhelming. They suggested the Privateers. The color scheme was brown. He said that they wanted the mascot to be a pirate and that the cheer was more fit for Jack Sparrow. I can't believe I'm saying this. He said the head of the marketing team said the cheer should be "arr," very literally. So the stick you saw Kurt holding there was something that he came across randomly, and the guy who made it pointed out a distinct brown line throughout the wood, and he said it signified wood that had been struck by lightning. So that sealed it for Stiers. He said the lightning to his Thunderbirds, and Halifax was reborn, John.
So cool, Ashley. Thank you for that. One of the best logos in the league, no doubt. And Stiers in the house tonight, hoping to see a much different result from his team in the second quarter as they try to come back against the Rock. Mazuka, lots of time, and Bold will make that save. Rock at home when leading in any quarter at its completion have not lost this season. 3-0 when leading out of the first. Halifax trying to change that tune when it matters most. Dawson tried the long shot, stuffed, and the Thunderbirds move up.
Halifax does have some success in this building, just one of two teams that have beaten the Toronto Rock at home. They also had two games in this building as home games when COVID-19 regulations shut down any opportunity of having home games in Halifax.
Nifty mitts by Shanks, who tried to split the wickets and just couldn't. Thunderbirds gonna need a big night from Austin Shanks, no doubt. And you're right, they have had success here. Just trying to refine that. Seems to be one of the themes of their late season, really, is how did they get back to the team that started the year that were just moving along at an incredible place, turning heads, giving whiplash around the league, and have not been able to find it as consistently down the stretch. But there's a lot of talent on the floor from Halifax. Jameson, little fake, moves in. Jameson on the move, seven to shoot. Fennell off the shoulder of Rose, who stood up to make that save. Thunderbirds get it back. Fennell switching hands, going righty there. Bushi, Jameson. Long range off the side of the net. Rose spots that quickly. Ain't far from over tonight, we know that much. But if you're Halifax, how do you regain some confidence?
Well, I think that last possession, yeah, you don't come away with a goal. Big stops like that from Aaron Bolt certainly will help as well, but a great offensive possession. You got some good chances, but unfortunately nothing coming. You can't force singles. You can't hit the home run. Just hit singles, get back into this game.
Clark Peterson trying to dial something up. Right into traffic. Thunderbirds look like they might get a second helping from Thede, who just levels the boom after losing that. Rock don't mind. They'll pay the price to go up the floor. Slade throws on the brakes. Reconfigures with the attack coming off the bench. Mans to the side. Good battle right down the pipe with Dawson and Withers. Long range drifter goes wide as Schreiber looking for three, and the shot clock will expire before that one got off. Peterson taking control for the Thunderbirds. Everyone knows what's at stake tonight. As for one team, the season will end. Single elimination game for the other. They're playing to get into the series, the next series, which is best two out of three. So that's still quite a tall task. Not a lot of time to make an impact, but that's the pressure on these players tonight, Pat, and everybody talking about how to try and channel that, maybe how to ignore it at times. Not easy. A little shimmy shake for Mans up top and won't find the bottom against Bold.
I think Dawson, before the game, talking to Ashley Dawkins, said it perfectly. It's just another lacrosse game, just has a lot bigger stakes at them.
Keo swings over. Toronto trying to keep him to the outside. There's a shot Nick Rose will take every day of the week. Thunderbirds get the ball back though. See how they set it up with 25. Just a steamroll play there by Thede. Hard to believe he was stopped with that kind of a locomotive coming right at you.
Dawson Thede's first game back in a little while here. Doesn't quite look as dynamic as we normally see. Might still be playing a little bit banged up.
Craig. Partial screen, Bolt up to stop that one. He's got a look down the floor. Tarasenko does catch up to it, but he had to reach for that one. Make coverage from Jubinville and others able to catch up as well. Harris working down deep in the trenches. Ball comes back to Tarasenko. Still a fight for it there. Mazuka. Rogers on the far side. And the Rock go off the bench. Quick stick at the side. And Bold comes over. He has been solid since replacing Warren Hill.
Well, let's be frank here. That's all he needs to be. Just make the saves that you need to make. Stop the bleeding here from the run that the Toronto Rock have had. And allow your team to chip away at this lead.
Brad Gilley setting it up for the Thunderbirds. And then in tight. Robinson had that look that he wanted. And it just slips away. 7 for 7 is Bold since coming into the game. Hellier lets it fly, and Rob Hellier is back on the scene. high stakes. A 5-goal lead for the Rock.
Oh, yeah, the Lions Head Ontario native. Looks pretty healthy to me, John. Look at the little jab step here. Comes through. Great pick there by Tom Schreiber to free up some space for the veteran. Comes around the top. And right before the defender can slide, he throws that sidearm down low, piping in. And the Rock leads 6-1.
Hellier had the big setup to help open the scoring for the Rock. On to Tom Schreiber. That time you mentioned, Schreiber, the help on that one is Tarasenko scores. He'll answer right back as Halifax tries to make up some ground.
The Thunderbirds rookie has never scored a bigger goal in his career, his first NLL playoff game. And how about this howitzer from the outside that beats Nick Rose? Great faceoff win by Jake Withers. And the two Buckeyes connect in transition. And that's that counterpunch we're talking about, John. We know McGrath, it's a game of runs.
Rock going right back. Slade on the move, and a piece of that on the way by from Bold. Erlin into the fray deep. Tarasenko had two helpers against the Rock in the regular season. You mentioned not a bigger goal for him this year. Trying to stop the Rock in their tracks a little bit. Man's off a body, and that finds the seats in Hamilton. Two goals in the second quarter. Hellier got it started for the Rock. And Tarasenko answering back for the Thunderbirds. Quest for back-to-back gold at the World Hockey Championship gets underway next Friday as they open their tournament against Germany. It all gets underway 1 Eastern, 10 Pacific, only on TSN. Terrific tournament in Finland this year. Red and white be well supported. The blue, red, and white in control in this one early as a Rock. That possession in against the Thunderbirds. Halifax trying to push up, and a long range shot stopped by Bold. Bell has positioning there. Thunderbirds is trying to up the energy. Obviously, they'd like to score, give themselves a little boost. Fennell, nice play, trying to cut to the inside, but then lost it. Gives the Rock a chance to eat a little more clock up the floor.
Wilts, but Mitch Disnew with the interception on the crease. All-world year by Dr. D, as they call him in these parts. Bolt, just enough of that Hellier attempt as he was looking for his second of the quarter. Tarasenko. Bushi now takes a look back. Picked by Keogh, they go straight across to Jamison off the bench. Protects, swings. Had a drive on his mind, lost control though. Fennell trying to get it back. And a loose ball scoop right there. Pat, if you're Halifax, what do you need to see?
You've got to see more energy. You mentioned it. Just the ball is dying in a lot of sticks, and the way and how many takeaway defenders this Rock team has, they're just foaming at the mouth trying to get that strip. And it's working almost every single time.
No question. Formidable opponent in the Toronto Rock, but Halifax, they some great players, just have not been able to strut their stuff.
I mean, this defense for Halifax is just absolutely suffocating.
Nice move to get in tight, up close and personal with Bold, who helps up Zach Mans. A little friendly assist there.
And this certainly is not going to help Halifax on a route to a possible comeback, as not only do they take a penalty, we'll let Mark Gardonio or Ian Garrison explain a legal cross-check, as it's also Luke Magnin going to sit down for two. He's one of their best penalty killers. We saw him miss a good chunk of the season due to injury, and it was no coincidence. As soon as Luke Magnin was out of the lineup, this penalty kill went down the drain.
We'll try to hold the fort against Toronto this time around. 0 for 1 on the Rock tonight. Blistering shot delivered by Craig, missing the mark. Withers wants to go. Thunderbirds, it's some time off the clock here, but they need goals. Peterson trying to drum one up. Pretty good opportunity, it seemed, but could not find the handle. Thunderbirds trying to claw their way back. Toronto up in the winner take all first half.
Witnessing an Alterna Cup battle tonight. That's any Canadian teams going head-to-head to try and win that.
The Alterna Cup belonging to the Calgary Roughnecks this year. The champions, Kim Mosley from Alterna, Brian Lemon from the league, and Mike Moore of the Roughnecks, happily taking that hardware home. They're taking on the Colorado Mammoth in their do-or-die elimination game. We'll have an update on that, a preview
in our guaranteed rate halftime reports. Lots of terrific action around the league, and doesn't get any better than when a playoff spot, playoff opportunity on the line right away, as it is tonight. Win and move on. Toronto stepping up to the pressure of this game thus far. Working on the power play. Driver gets it back. Rogers in. Nice little tap dance at the side by Dawson. Couldn't make it work. Saved by Craig. Dan Craig. Dawson with Rogers in behind. Rogers back to Craig. Missed. Rogers resets. Dawson denied by Bold. Rogers picks it up. Shriver to Rogers on the Rock power play. Craig with a high pick set. Rogers. Dawson scores! What finish from the veteran as Dan Dawson earns a power play goal for Toronto. This is just gorgeous ball movement. Look at that ball spin around. A little behind the back, Callum Rogers across there. And it just, look at, bam, 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 bam. Look at, how, first off, how does Dan Dawson get that wide open? But Aaron Bold just looking absolutely lost as he's got to track that ball over. But the legend of Dan Dawson continues as he scores another playoff point, second all-time playoff point, continuing just to climb that ladder. And we're crunching numbers, Pat, as Keough tries to answer back. Rose made the save, and it dropped at his feet. He'll scoop it up. Remarkable what Dawson's done over his well-documented playoff career.
Averaging 5.24 playoff points in his career. Just remarkable stuff. 152 coming into this game.
Also tells you how many times he's been to the dance. And of course, his records, his place in the league, three-time champion, all of that. And now he's finishing the regular season into another postseason at the age of 40 as the hot shot sneaks through. Shanks, we're waiting for him to appear and just did, beating Rose with a laser.
Austin Shanks has entered the chat, scoring his first goal of the game, and it's a big one again. Another reply, and just when you think maybe the Toronto Rock are going to go on another run, Austin Shanks scores a big goal right off the faceoff. John, another goal off an early possession from the faceoff. The Thunderbirds are going to want to come back. Number 33 is going to have to play a big role.
Shanks can be the spark that lights the fire, has been this year at times for the Thunderbirds. Erland off the hop. Oh, and that one stung Aaron Bold. He is still in some discomfort in that Halifax net, trying his hardest to shake it off with 2.5 to go to the halftime, guaranteed rate halftime. Shanks nearly pulled it off again. The Snow scores! Mitch the Snow has two! And the Rock go back up the floor to add another.
What an unbelievable run Mitch the Snow is on. He scored in five straight games. That's his second of the game, and that shot is so hard to track where it's going. He's got that long release, the big windup, and he'll throw it sidearm sometimes. He'll throw it over the top. His first two-goal game of his career. Calling it a career year for Mitch Disnew is understating it quite a bit, John.
Again, he's been such a centerpiece of this Toronto defense that's worked its wonders all year. You see him scoring goals, you think maybe that's part of his arsenal. Well, it is tonight, but he'll get accolades for the other side of the ball. Dawson just pulling his way in, shoots, and a stop by Bold. Peterson in a hurry, one-on-one. Swings over, and what a stop by Rose to shut down Thede. Now the transition game opens up, things speed up.
And that's the tough thing here, John. Obviously, you're Halifax, you got to push. And Dan Craig scoring a quick strike here for the Thunderbirds. For the Rock, sorry. But he has owned the Thunderbirds. 20 points, John, coming into this game. Again, it's another slow change, but the Rock have done a great job recognizing when that slow change is coming. And it's a backdoor cut right on Armstrong. A great cut from Craig. We know he's such a great shooter from the outside, but showing off his stuff. When he's in tight, he can bury it too.
Not much room there for Craig, but you're right. He has just had the Halifax number. Bell denied by Rose. Fantastic left arm stop. Yeah, the points don't lie when it comes to Craig versus Halifax this year.
And what I was going to say about Halifax is that you want to play fast because you want to start to spark some offense from transition, but you're just playing right into the hand of Toronto. That's what they want to do. They want to get into a track meet.
Mazzucca curls around. Dawson directing traffic. Craig out of the corner. Let's it fly. Long range. Missed the mark. Halifax up the floor looking at shot clock just under the game clock. Shanks. Might get something going. Lots of stick work to cut through. Nearly made it. Couldn't. And Toronto just peppering the Halifax net. 35 shots. One short of double digits on the board. They'll take some time with this possession near the end of the first half to draw something up, but at times, stifling out there. If you're the Halifax Thunderbirds, and it's just going to take some hard work to try and break through that.
This is the most recent goal that we've seen. Look at Hellier. He's slowing things down, and then I think just Halifax defense falling asleep, thinking it's a slow change, but instead Craig sees the back of Armstrong's head, beats him to the net, and scores. And John, you said it, man. This Toronto Rock offense, they can score in so many different ways. You talk about them playing their best at the right time, but it's not like they're, you know, just picking it up in the last couple of weeks, heading in the postseason. It's been like this for a couple of months now.
Thunderbirds did win their last two of the regular season to try and give them a bit of a boost after quite the slide. Rock trying to get one late one here. Set up to Dawson off the backboard sharply. Disnew comes in as the buzzer sounds. And that is a strong opening half for Toronto.
Toronto did it in so many ways. Transition, defense, Nick Rose was sharp. The offense just absolutely buzzing. 9 goals in the first half.
5 in the first quarter for Toronto, followed up with another 4 in the second. Thunderbirds finding a little bit of life, but they have some work to do. No doubt they'll order up a big second half. Our guaranteed rate halftime report will arrive when we come back. Fun battle thus far between Halifax and Toronto in the playoffs.
And we also want to do a shout out to everybody who's celebrating their birthday here with us tonight. Our birthday is way off the beginning. Happy birthday, everyone.
Joined by Mitch Disnew, the newest recipient of the Les Bartley Award. Part of that award means commitment to team. For your team today, have you guys committed to the execution of your game plan so far, and are you happy with the results at this point?
I mean, yeah, it's a great start. Everywhere, buzzing on all ends of the floor. Offense, defense, goaltendings look good so far, but it's just a start. It's a good start, that's all it is.
There's always room for improvement, so is there anything that you guys need to sharpen up a little bit? What does the next gear look like for you in the second half?
I mean, just little mental things, like that last shot that we let in, we could have stepped up. There was no reason for that shot to be left open, and I think we can just close out the little things, win a couple more loose ball battles, and we'll be sitting pretty.
Thank you for your time, Mitch.
Thank you.
Back to you, John.
It's a guaranteed rate halftime report. As the do or die matchup has lots of Rock fans loving what they've seen after the first half. A 9-3 lead for Toronto, and one of their biggest contributors is standing by with Ashley Dockin.
Joined by Mitch Disnew, the newest recipient of the Les Bartley Award. Part of that award means commitment to team. For your team today, have you guys committed to the execution of your game plan so far, and are you happy with the results at this point?
I mean, yeah, it's a great start. Everywhere, buzzing on all ends of the floor. Offense, defense, goaltendings look good so far, but it's just a start. It's a good start, that's all it is.
There's always room for improvement, so is there anything that you guys need to sharpen up a little bit? What does the next gear look like for you in the second half?
I mean, just little mental things, like that last shot that we let in, we could have stepped up. There was no reason for that shot to be left open, and I think we can just close out the little things, win a couple more loose ball battles, and we'll be sitting pretty.
Thank you for your time, Mitch.
Thank you.
Back to you, John.
Thank you, Ashley. The Snoo hoping to be in the driver's seat. Two goals in the first. We'll break it down when we come back on TSN. Thank you. Welcome back to the Guaranteed Rate Halftime Report. You know, we knew it was going to be a tug of war, Pat, all night, and it started out like that.
Yeah, the stakes are high. We know these teams don't like each other, but when you mix in the playoffs, it is gritty, tough-nosed lacrosse, and we saw these guys go toe-to-toe early on.
Then Toronto started to take over, and they would go on a run.
John, I said this team can score in a bunch of ways, and that's exactly what they did. Schreiber blast that one from Bay Street. Then we see Zach Manns get in on the action, picks up the loose ball, takes it hard to the net, and beats Warren Hill. And the scoring wouldn't stop there. And this is just hang this in the loop. This is beautiful stuff. The turnover by Desnoux. And Latrell Harris takes flight, twister, bam, in the back of the net. And of course, Tom Schreiber said he wasn't done. Scores his second from deep, almost at the restraining line. And the Rock offense continues. The transition game has been unbelievable. This guy right here, Mitch Desnoux, an absolute bomb. One of his two goals he scored in.
Thunderbirds had no answer in the first. Then the goaltending changed, looking for some momentum. It seemed to work early on for Aaron Bold and the Thunderbirds.
Yeah, the former NLL final MVP really making some big stops, calming things down. And I felt that the Halifax Thunderbirds were poised for a little bit of a comeback based on how well he was playing inside the crease. But obviously things changed and the legend continues to grow as you see. Look at this perfect ball movement. Look at Dan Dawson in the corner. How can you forget about one of the greatest players in the game? Look, no one's looking at him. Little flip feed behind the back, bam, right in the back of the net. That is a thing of beauty, John. Dan Dawson, second most points in playoff NLL history, showing why he is one of the GOATs.
Oh, he's been there, done that, but looking like half his age on that nice finish. And we talked about some of the stats to keep track of. Yes, the Thunderbirds winning the face-off battle, but look at the disparity in shots on goal. My goodness, it has been a shooting gallery for the Rock out there.
It certainly has, but how about the power plays as well? Kudos to Toronto, playing physical, but staying out of the box.
It is certainly a game that we're enjoying in Hamilton, but my goodness, this is just the best time of year, Pat, because yes. There's plenty going on out around the National Lacrosse League. In the same scenario, the win and move on mentality is alive. And you see Philadelphia, a bit of an underdog crossing over. We'll meet San Diego, Buffalo and Albany, an all New York battle. And then Calgary and Colorado is going to be a thing of beauty as well, as Grant Farhall and Brad Chaloner help tee up that matchup.
Welcome to Calgary, Alberta, where tonight it will be the Calgary Roughnecks hosting the Colorado Mammoth in the Western Conference quarterfinal. It is a playoff matchup that we have seen many times before. These two teams have come together head-to-head, but a matchup dominated by the Calgary Roughnecks.
Yeah, a really freakishly lopsided playoff battle when you talk about these two teams, Grant. 10-1, Calgary's had Colorado's number over the years in the postseason. And, you know, these two teams, there's going to be no surprises tonight. Two teams, this is the fourth time they've seen each other so far this season. They played against each other a week ago. This has pretty much got a series vibe to it. And it's all going to be led by Curtis Dixon.
Yeah, Curtis Dixon, obviously the offensive weapon for the Calgary Roughnecks, went off last week.
5 goals in a row, a 6-goal night. We call that a sock trick here in the National Lacrosse League. Just one of those nights, shoot till you're hot. He had over 15 shots on goal against one of the best goaltenders in the world in Dylan Ward. And talking to Curtis Dixon midweek, he said really didn't think he was doing anything special. Just one of those nights when the ball was dropping for him. And we'll see if he can do that again here tonight.
So will the Calgary dominance continue against the Colorado Mammoth? We'll find out when ball drops in about 1 hour. See you then.
Thank you very much, gentlemen. Yeah, can hardly wait. And it is like New Year's Eve almost when you think about the ball being dropped on that matchup. That's later to come. You can find it on tsn.ca. And then rounding the weekend out, we mentioned already the head-to-head matchups. Of course, the out-of-town scoreboard presented by Sports Interaction as we get set for a wild and crazy weekend with our NLL playoff race, the chase for the championship heating up. Got to have snacks when you're enjoying a good game. And hey, on Mother's Day weekend, let's take a load off. Have the boys get to the game. Back with the second half. seats, but maybe not for long, as we have thoroughly enjoyed one half of action as the NLL playoffs begin, presented by Sports Interaction on TSN. Onlookers from both teams hoping that the second half doesn't disappoint. And how could it when playoff spot is on the line, Pat? That's the type of pressure these athletes play for all year. And that's why there's plenty to cheer for both teams. But, Pat, this is a do-or-die moment for the Halifax Thunderbirds. Who's going to lead the charge, lead the way?
I think it's that man right there, a guy that's won at every single level, a three-time NLL Cup champion. He's won in college. He's won in the summer game. This is a guy who is an ultimate leader. And I know he's not the player he once was, but he has to be that vocal leader.
Encountering him, Jalen Rogers, who is part of a veteran group, no doubt, on that Toronto side, but he's grown into that role with the C on his chest.
And he certainly has. You look at Jameson, a vocal, a rah-rah leader, but this guy is a guy that leads by example. There isn't many players that work harder on the floor and off the floor, for that matter, than Jalen Rogers.
Coming into tonight, the Rock have surrendered 106 goals at home, or pardon me, scored 106 goals at home. And they haven't surrendered much either, just 30 goals against in the third quarter. The lowest in the NLL, so it is the Halifax Thunderbirds that are going to try and fight their way back. And coming right down the pipe right away are the Rock with an opportunity. Bold able to hold his ground. It's easy for us to say that the Thunderbirds need to dig in, but here is Withers with a goal to start the third quarter. Just what Halifax needed.
They call this guy the Wiz, and it's absolute magic from Withers. He loses the faceoff, but is able to grab that loose ball off the shot, still has his faceoff stick in his hand, dances through a couple of bodies, and just perfectly places that shot. John, this isn't an overpowering shot. It's just an absolute snipe. We talk about how good he is at the faceoffs. This guy is one of the best all-around players in the game.
Well, we know Micah Kersey is passionate. He has the pedigree, having played. And I'm sure there was a rallying moment for Halifax in between the second and third quarter here at halftime, and they've come out with a goal. So see if that's a building moment. Shanks off the post, off Rose, and it just stays out. So indeed, this is a Thunderbirds team that does not plan on going quietly into the night.
Absolutely not. I don't know what was said in that locker room, but it's certainly working so far. The Rock are 8-0 after leading at halftime this season, but we've seen the Thunderbirds come back from some crazy, crazy deficits.
Jameson, long range, turned aside by Rose. Last time they met in the regular season, 15-7 win for Toronto. The Rock outscored Thunderbirds 7-1 in the second half. Halifax didn't forget that. They were embarrassed. Pride was on the line. Well, that's not the biggest motivating factor tonight, but they certainly would like to flip the script. Quick stick attempt didn't work at the side. Oh, a lunging play to keep that alive for Toronto. Just over a dozen to shoot as they work it all the way back. Try and set something up. Rob Hellier, in his return, sends one right into Bold. Let's rejoin Ashley Dockin.
Speaking with Luke Magnin earlier this week, I asked him, you know, what do you guys need to do if the game is not going well? He said, mainly control our emotions. Toronto is a good team. We're playing in their barn. It's going to be rocking. He's like, plus the last time we played them, it didn't go well, and we remember that. He's like, we are not going to let that happen again. There's pride involved here, you guys. They have some work to do, but that early goal by Withers is a good sign.
Thank you, Ashley, for expanding on that and absolutely giving us a little insight into the mindset of Halifax. There's a loose ball pickup. Looked like it was all drawn up for Robinson to put a ball on it. And Shanks, previous to that, hitting the post again. You saw that emotion come out. Boy, it's a fine line between good and bad emotion, isn't it, Pat, out there?
Exactly. You got to just dial them in. The stakes are so high. You don't want to get too high, but you also don't want to get too low.
Quick stick, and Dawson can't pick the far corner. Yeah, it can fuel you, but you don't want it to let it get the better of you.
There's no doubt about that. And if you are Halifax, you can't just expect scoring that big goal from Withers. You're going to score the next possession and the next possession after that. You have to slowly, slowly work up to it. And I think that's the momentum that they're going to try to take to make this comeback possible.
Jameson nearly found a bouncer working his way. Off the one hopper. Rogers will wait for the rest to catch up behind him. Shriver, a rip. Off the mark. Looked like the rock were going to get back to it. Armstrong will pursue and prevail. Armstrong again and nearly made that look, but those are the ones that are hard to see pass up.
They haven't had a ton of transition opportunities. The Rock done a great job getting back. So if you have an opportunity like that, you got to take it.
Well, we expect the battle to continue as it did right off the start of this lacrosse game, and opportunity for Halifax.
Draw number 26 commits to the lacrosse channel.
Rip penalty for Shriver. This has been an area that has plagued the Thunderbirds all season. But if there was ever a time to turn around a power play output, it would be in a game they need to win. Thunderbirds go to work in their first man advantage. Jameson scores! The captain makes quick work on the power play, trying to surge his Thunderbirds back in this one.
There's quick striking, and then there's whatever Cody Jameson just did there. Short work on that shooter side. Clark Peterson feeds it over. We'll see it right here. Just a little bit of space, and that is a perfect skipper by Jameson. John, we always see him throw that little twister. He's so deceptive that time. He decides just to go old school, bouncer over the shoulder into the net.
He had 7 power play goals in the regular season. That's the biggest of the season. Especially a Halifax power play that was dead last overall, dead last on the road. They have persevered to get a big goal here in the third. Gap now at 4. Halifax has the first 2 goals of the third. Jameson works back up top. Pressure from Creed. Backs up the Thunderbirds a bit. For now, lets it fly. Piece of that. Looked like a piece from Rose. They'll play on into the court.
I hope someone took a picture of Tom Shriver in the box there, because that was just his 5th penalty in his NLL career. Yeah. I know there's no Lady Bing Award in the National Lacrosse League, but certainly would be up for it. Plays a clean game, but a mean game.
Halifax on a 7-2 shot run, so they've recognized more balls to Rose is just part of the equation. Hossick up to Keogh. Slow trot. Peterson back to Keogh. Pick set by Bushi. Keogh couldn't skip one in. Hard hit right in front. And it gives the Rock the possession back. Rogers deceptive with that look and bolt. Didn't bite. Rogers out of a pile. Back up top. Dawson. Gonna slow his roll a little bit. Lots of time on the shot clock. Hounded though. Ball came free. Unlike Dan Dawson to let that one slip out. And as Campbell sprints up the floor, teams come together once again. Thunderbirds needed a response. They find it in the third. Back-to-back goals to open it up. And they narrow the gap on Toronto in this playoff tilt.
We're still accepting team positive. If you win tonight, we're going to be
The MLS on TSN continues Sunday with an all-Canadian matchup as the Caps go head-to-head with TFC. Coverage begins at 3:30 Eastern, 12:30 Pacific on TSN and CTV. By that time, we'll have a good idea of the next round of playoff matchups. And these fans hoping Toronto will be in that conversation, but some game to go yet. Halifax making a strong case here in the third quarter as they continue to enjoy power play time. Work for them once, trying to make it work again. Awesome.
I know he didn't catch the ball, but how did Cody Jamison match feet there? You said it, John. What a time would it be for this power play to wake up. 2 for 2, Shanks gets his second. You see Keogh in the middle start distracting. Look at how far over they are. They're worried about Keogh in the middle. They slough over, and that just gives way too much time, way too much space for the former Buckeye of the Ohio State, Austin Shanks. Cuts this lead to just a 3.
Yeah, he is a driver for Halifax, and he's woken up. Here come the Rock, though.
I tell you, when Latrell Harris runs in transition, I swear someone presses the fast forward button. The guy has absolute wheels.
That was a trail ablaze. Mans. Lime Schreiber. Up top, McKenna. Missing, trying to get it back. Thunderbirds converge. This is the opportunity to swing this game. 3 straight to start the third quarter, 2 on the power play. Uncharacteristic to their season to cash in that way. They're digging deep, are the Thunderbirds. Thede looking back across. Keogh with the screen. Scores! And how about that emotion and celebration from the veteran Keogh? And it's a 2-goal game.
We talked about players with playoff pedigree, championships. Well, who else but Steven Keogh? He has won at virtually every level, including this one in the National Lacrosse League. Great pick by Clark Peterson, but Keogh unloads that patented shot. And of course, finishes it off with a touch of the turf. 2 goals now.
3 join Ashley Docking.
Thanks so much, you guys. One of the things Austin Shanks told us this week is that the leadership group on this team has been pivotal in helping this team overcome their shortcomings so far this season. And then what do we see in this instance? 4 goals back to back to back. Jamison and Keogh, 2 of the elder statesmen, 2 of the leaders, leading the way with Withers and Shanks himself in the mix. Austin Shanks is a confidence player. When he sees that ball go into the net, you've got to watch out. John?
Certainly do. What a submarine play there, trying to get the Rock to an extended lead. Thank you, Ashley. Yet those are some of the marquee names the Thunderbirds made hay with at the beginning of the year.
Well, those were big, important names when this team last went on a championship run with Shanks, Withers, and of course Jameson.
Hell, you're all alone! And Barry's! Rob Hellyer on a beautiful setup, and the Rock have 10.
This is just a thing of beauty. Look at how far up the Thunderbirds are playing, so aggressive, and it's Graham Hossick who gets blown up on a pick. We'll see it right here. Hossick goes up to take his man, and Schreiber. Hellyer throws the pick, a behind the back sweet feed, and a great finish by Hellyer, scoring his 2nd goal. We knew he was going to play a big role coming back into this lineup.
So back and forth we go. This is more of what we expected right off the hop. It just took a half to get there. Open look. Rose doing a good job following that one right to left is Peterson in that marquee spot trying to cash in. Thede lets it fly up top. Anybody's ball came down and Rose for good measure pushed over. Didn't have to make a stop, but after the whistle.
Mentioned those two goals from Elliott. He also has two assists coming into this game. He was averaging just under four. So, I mean, just some guys are just clutch, and that certainly is the case for Rob Elliott.
Well, Pat, you played this sport at a high level. You know how tough it is coming back off of injury, never mind into a playoff game. And Elliott would make you believe he didn't miss any time.
And I think they were very sure to make sure that he wasn't going to re-aggravate anything, because let's be honest, obviously they want to win this game, but they have their eyes on the big prize, winning a championship. They don't want to force him in if it's going to risk them potentially down the road in a possible championship run.
Both these teams feeling they could be poised for that. Shanks again, and they're working it back to the hot stick.
Well, if you're Halifax, you got to realize, okay, you knew you weren't just going to roll and tie the game up right away. There was going to be a counterpunch by Toronto. Now you got to see, if you're the Thunderbirds, how do you react after that goal?
Shoulder stop by Bold. McKenna, second look, lots of time on the shot clock reset for the Rock. Shriver all the way around. Dishes, he's been shooting tonight. Didn't expect that. Dawson was certainly open. The Thunderbird steal. Bell, some daylight. Scores! Tyson Bell rings it. And the Thunderbirds have come alive in the third.
And Tyson Bell points up to the corner where a big cheering section for the Thunderbirds and his family from St. Catharines just down the road are fired up. And he scores in transition. This is just a great move. It looks like he's going to run out of space, but instead fake, and just goes right across the body of Nick Rose. This is a guy that has won a championship before with Calgary back in 2019. He knows what it takes to win, and he has been tremendous here tonight.
It seemed at times this was Toronto going to open up a big gap. It has certainly been filled by the Thunderbirds, but here's a pretty play, and airborne didn't work that time for the Toronto Rock. For Tom Shriver, don't go anywhere. The entertainment continues right here in the third. Playoff lacrosse on TSN. Hawk offense on a roll, in part to the return of Rom Hellier, who has been absolutely lights out despite missing time. First game since April the 1st, if you can believe it, Pat.
It's crazy. A full month and a bit off, but he hasn't missed a beat. It's just been vintage Rom Hellier. Look at how quick he's moving out there. That jab step, that great release, and he's a guy, won a Minto Cup in junior lacrosse in 2012. He wants to add another trophy to his shelf with the NLL Cup. Look at right there, calm, cool, collected. He knows Halifax Thunderbirds were gonna come back, but now it's their time to go on a run here.
It was a 5-goal run for Toronto in the first, a 4-goal run for the Thunderbirds in the third, and the Hellier goal getting Toronto to 10 from number 10. Not done yet, not even close. In this head-to-head battle, winner take all in the NLL playoffs presented by Sports Interaction on TSN. Rose deflects up and out.
That's a great possession shot by Robinson. Not much on the clock. Instead, you take that shot, hoping it goes off the shoulder and out. And that's exactly what happens. The Thunderbirds now with another possession here, with some tired defenders on the floor too.
And Halifax not only closing the gap on the scoreboard, but as Jamison breaks free, lets it rip. Rose stopping that. They've upped their shot tally significantly. Now under 10 away from The Rock, who had a big advantage there as well. Shriver. On to Rogers. Curls up top. Craig on the move, slicing back. Can't get around Terepenko. Plays one right through. Dirty peck up there from Shriver. No dunk option. Swings one with the backhand. Right through the top of the crease, and the clock expires.
Well, we talked about how well this Halifax offense has come to life. We got to give enough praise to this defense. They've been so good, so fast, aggressive. They're playing with energy, that energy that we saw this defense play with in the first half of this season. And of course, you can't forget the veteran Aaron Bold has been so steady in between the pipes.
Yeah, that was an element I thought might work against them if the Halifax Thunderbirds and Keogh, if they had to move on from Hill in the game. And yet, you're bang on, Pat. Bold has settled in, provided some confidence again, and this is a much different looking Thunderbirds group in this second half. Bodies jammed up in tight. Ball ricocheted to Rose, and he'll play that one on. Rock running the floor. Circling the wagons, Desnoux, who has two in his pocket tonight. Long range shot. He makes good. Mans beating Bold from a long way out.
We know Zach Mans has been a great secondary scoring option for this Rock team, but when it comes to the Thunderbirds, he's been lights out. He's owned this team. 11 points coming into this game against the T-Birds. Gets another goal here. He had 7 points in this building in this season against Halifax, and for whatever reason, he has this team's number.
There's part of the difficulty of taking on the Rock in this position they've climbed themselves into. Second in the East is that their offense has stayed dynamic, plenty of options, and really hard to game plan for.
Coming into the season, everyone talked about how dynamic and electric the righties were, but the lefties have stepped up big time.
Well, your curls and lets it fly. Bull making the stop on that left side. Bell. Bushi has some pace. Peterson trying to set a pick. Oh, quick stick by Robinson out of nowhere. Couldn't cash in. Bushi mucking it up. Peterson, the benefactor. He tries to swing in. One hand on the stick. Couldn't cut through. Let Blue Forest protecting Nick Rose. Rogers on the run. And taken down just after he let that one go.
one hand on the stick, you said, what a bad idea when Brad Cree is in the area. He is one of the best take-away defenders in the game. I know Clark Peterson's a great player, but gotta keep two hands on that stick when he's around.
Z drops it at his feet. DeSnu involved. Keel, ball comes out again. And that one, one, and scooped up by Latrell Harris. Yeah, loose balls, forced turnovers. That has been a hallmark of that Toronto D. DeSnu, Cree, Harris leading the way all year. Dawson. Around the horn. Gets it back, shoots, scores! Dan Dawson still doing it! And he increases the Rock lead.
40 years old, and Dan Dawson is still oh so dangerous. See the ball swing to the other side. Graham Hossick plays that angle well, but he's got to get to hands. Just because you're standing there covering your man doesn't mean you're doing your job. You got to get a stick on him, got to get a body on him, because as Dan Dawson showed here tonight, he might be one of the oldest players in the game, but he can still do it.
Third straight two-goal game for Dawson. Just before the quarter, runs out. What a third that was. The Rock tested. The Thunderbirds come to life. Orchestrate a little bit more offensively, as we've known them to do. And then Toronto continues to separate, setting up a spectacular force. Playoff spot on the line when we come back to Hamilton on TSN.
More than any player per game in the NLL, and went on a five-game run starting in January, then roll it.
Plenty of excitement in the game, and everybody on their toes tonight in Hamilton. Rock take the lead into the fourth. More on their side of the ball. Let's join Ashley Docking.
Thank you, John. Tom Schreiber had 47 goals this season, more than anyone per game in the NLL. He had a particularly impressive five-goal run starting at the end of January, the 29th, spanning until February 26th, where he scored 19 goals, totaled 31 points, and it happened to coincide with his return after the birth of his daughter. Now, where have we seen this dad strength before? Well, it's Mr. Fred VanVleet of the Toronto Raptors, you guys. Fred was slumping during the Raptors' 2019 run, but in the Eastern Conference Finals against the Bucks, he had a baby and boom, popped off with subsequent explosion of points all the way to the NBA title. 22 points in the game-clinching game six versus the Golden State Warriors. Schreiber says dad strength is real. He's like, it's a slow drip. I don't know when it turns off. Adversity of less sleep, more responsibility around the house has translated into making me a more resilient athlete. So shout out to all the dads, John.
Thank you very much, Ashley. Yeah, that's a real thing. He was even in the box twice tonight for Schreiber with that dad strength. A couple of baby boomers. Nice parallel to one of the leading men for the Toronto Raptors. Yeah, that's the difference at the top level in the pros. Playing against man, and right off the hop, starting the fourth, like the third, Jameson brings his team into the battle.
I don't want to tap my back and give myself some credit here, John, but what did I say? If anything was going to spark a comeback, it would be this guy here. And I don't know if I knew, though, he would be this good. Look at him get the ball here, comes across, and he is playing like the old Cody Jameson. This is why he is one of the greatest goal scorers to ever play the game. We know he is the emotional leader of this team. Well, now he's playing like one of the best players on the team.
Talking about winning everything, he has a lot of accolades as well. He's not ready to call it quits on the season. And Jameson, you're right. Absolutely right. Identified the leader for the Halifax Thunderbirds, who desperately wants to see that score continue to change. They've started the quarters, first two quarters of the second half, with a head of steam pass. Scoring in the first 30 seconds of the third, first 30 seconds of the fourth. Is there more? Rose shuts down Bell that time before Thede just wallpapers the area behind Nick Rose.
No call on the play for the hit. It was actually he ran through the crease and touched the ball, so crease violation. The Toronto Rock will get a chance here to make sure that the Halifax Thunderbirds don't go on another run like we saw early in the last third quarter.
Rogers just missed. Thunderbirds will have a chance to set it up with that ball coming back.
You mentioned it, Jameson, just the ultimate leader, won at Syracuse national championships, Minto Cup, Man Cup.
Robinson off the crossbar. He's had a few interactions in tights.
And John, I'll be honest, I didn't see what happened. It was behind the play. Cree and Jameson both gonna sit off here as Ian Garrison escorts them off. We'll see right here. A little crashing, banging, a couple of healthy pops. Just having a little bit of an argument there. And for playoff lacrosse,
roughing, 5-on-5.
Mr. Garrison, I have to disagree, but play will go on. It'll be 5-on-5.
Yet taking them both.
Exactly. If you're gonna make them sit, at least grab both of them. Those are the two of the most fun players to watch in both teams.
I was just about to say that's a great battle, especially heating up the way Jameson has in this second half. Gillies on the move, scores! What a snipe as Gillies continues the Thunderbirds' roll.
Are you kidding me, Brad Gillies? Coast to coast goes the former RIT Tiger. Little face dodge and just a flick of the wrist in the back of the net. We'll get a great look here, face dodge. And that is a perfectly executed play by Brad Gillies, who does not get enough credit for being an unsung hero on defense in transition for the T-Birds, John.
From 5-1 down to 9-3 down to now a two spot. The Thunderbirds slowly chipping away. Rock still up 12-10. Bushi. Thunderbirds get it back. Keo not gonna have an opportunity. Scoop that cleanly. Some feathers ruffled at the side. And up the floor go the Rock.
Harris. Driver dishes, Craig. Swings over.
Great slide by Magnet.
Backhand by McKenna doesn't fly, blocked in front of Bold. And the Thunderbirds come up the floor. This is really the most we've seen Toronto push back in this game as they go through a little adversity. Thunderbirds trying to keep it going. Shanks started to wake up, had a clean shot, passed in front. Bushi leveled by Rogers, might have saved a goal there from Challen Rogers.
Halifax wanted a call there for the hit on the back.
Slade had the give and go, all designed off the tip of the stick. Sprinting the other way, Tarasenko, who's factored in tonight.
This might be his best game as a pro so far, and it's coming to the biggest one, John.
Peterson scores! Seen eye shot from Clark Peterson, and the Thunderbirds are within one.
There is zero quit in this team. Talking to Mike Kersey all week long, he said he was so proud of the resiliency of this team. And yes, they had their ups and their downs, but they finished with two wins. They start slow in this game, but they don't give up. And Clark Peterson led the team in points with 72, scores the biggest goal of the season so far, and it's an absolute beauty to get this to a one-goal game.
Peterson had 16 points against the Rock in three games in the regular season. Now a goal to go with three assists tonight. And that was another check mark for the Thunderbirds. Shanks, check. Jameson, check. Peterson, check. And if you're the Rock, this is a little too close for comfort. Credit Halifax for battling back in this game. Wide open look, and Bold says no to Hellier. Good look back on that stop. Tarasenko searching for room.
22-10 is the shots. Sorry, 11 now for Halifax in the second half.
Shanks gets the pick from Keogh, shoots, and a left arm stop by Rose.
Huge loose ball.
Keogh, point blank, denied by Rose. Answering right back to Bold at the other end. Would you want it any other way? A one goal game with under 10 to go in the final quarter.
Look at Fennell with that cause turnover, picks up the loose ball. This is what playoff lacrosse is all about.
Jameson. Keogh scores! Steve Keogh has brought the game to a tie. The Thunderbirds have come all the way back. What a story Halifax has written in this second half.
9-3 in the first half. Halifax is trailing. Instead, they flip this game on its head and outscore Toronto 9-3 in this half. Are you kidding me? Stephen Keogh has played in some big games before. The dude has ice in his veins.
Four straight goals in the fourth for the Thunderbirds. And it's tied up at 12. Can they make it five? Feed. Welcome to the party. Five straight goals for the Thunderbird, and they lead it 13-12. Well, that's playoff lacrosse, baby.
The big rig, Dawson Feed, scores a massive goal here. As we'll see, the ball gets swung right over, and it's a quick strike. Feed's a big body, but he has some great finesse to him. It looks like he's going to try to pick the corners here, but it's a deceptive shot. Instead, it goes down low, and the Thunderbirds have their first lead of this game.
their first lead, and it arrives in the fourth quarter with the game on the line, their season on the line. Still lots of time, but what a remarkable comeback to insert themselves into this lacrosse game. Shanks into the middle, and Rose pushes back, got just enough of that. Rock on their heels. They've been shaken. Man's in tight. Harris will keep the possession alive. Foundation is cracked a little bit on the Rock here. Craig trying to make something happen. Right into Bold, who signifies he's got it. Simply incredible. Halifax have battled all the way back and now lead at 13-12 in the fourth. Amazing lacrosse. This has been remarkable. I mean, are you not entertained at this moment? On the left side, Matt Sawyer is going, what happened to our lead and our stake in this winner-take-all game? And Micah Kersey had belief in his team. The second half has been simply incredible.
Absolute banana land stuff here in Hamilton, Halifax. Like, we knew they are capable of comebacks. But this is insane.
We all know the run that the Rock went on near the end of the year to finish second to secure home floor. And rightly so, trumpeted as DeSnew moves up, plays it to the side. Thunderbirds, they were in the middle of a slide at that exact same time. They were going the other way. But one thing to Kersey signified to us is that he believed in that team. They maintained their poise through adversity, showed a lot about the players in that room. They felt they went through it at the perfect time. Schreiber comes right back for Toronto to tie it up again.
Who else but Tom Terrific, Captain America. Call him whatever you want to call him, John. Right now, he might be the best lacrosse player on the planet. Just a huge goal and a huge moment from a huge player in Schreiber. 10th hat trick of the season. What a goal scoring.
Hossick with a double-double. Couldn't beat Rose. Schreiber, his third of the game to tie it at 13. I cannot wait to see where this one goes.
Energy back into this building.
Long Ranger up and out.
Great trail check from Toronto there. The defense has to step up. They got to start playing that aggressive style. They were way too packed in the second half. Get back to what was working well.
Craig, Toronto could use some of his magic. Rock in a battle. Gillies helps break it up. Bell will steal and move up the floor. This is where every part of you becomes tested physically in an all-out grind in a wonderful battle for us to watch. Fidel test Rose, able to make that stop. Moved up the floor by Rogers, shoots, and how did Bolt get a piece of that one? Pace slowed just a touch. Time enough for us to check in with Ashley Dockey.
Thanks, guys. Halifax has done a really nice job taking away some of those transition looks the Rock had in the first half. The coaching staff encouraging them, get off quickly, nothing changes. It clearly has been a focus for them here tonight, guys.
Thank you, Ashley. Shanks, wide. The Snoo the other way. Harris in front of him. The Snoo sends it over. And Harris looked like he had it all sewn up. The Thunderbirds able to get back in time.
Wow, Clark Peterson with an absolute hero check there. Gets back in reverse transition, breaks up almost a sure thing of a goal.
Shot clock about to expire. Craig's gonna have to try it, he does. This is not next goal wins, but it feels like it right now. Bucci, a hole, point blank misses. That was daylight, everything he wanted, and could not find the handle. Halifax gets back to the ball. Shanks, piece of the stick by Cree, interfering with that drive. And the shot clock will run out. Slade. Both teams relying on their defenses. Try and calm things down a little bit. It's been a marvelous run of offense. Hellier, been buzzing all night. Shoots, partial block there, kicks it back out. Craig Castile, and they'll let the shot clock go. It does not get any better than this in playoff lacrosse. Presented by Sports Interaction. More coming on TSN. Tonight's turning points presented by Fanatics.ca. What a run the Thunderbirds went on, Pat.
Well, the Thunderbirds miraculously were able to close the gap to 12-8, but then they scored five straight goals to start the fourth quarter. Stephen Keogh ties the game up. And the first lead of the game comes from Dawson Theed Stick, the former Whippy Warrior, getting it done here. But now we're tied at 13-13 late in this fourth quarter. What an unreal comeback it's been for Halifax, but kudos to Toronto. They threw that counterpunch.
What was Dan Dawson telling our Ashley Docking before we started?
Yep.
This is the moment you dream of. Who's going to be the hero? Thinking about the game on your stick. Might end up that way tonight. Keo. Undeniable. In stop, Rose Keo. Did he get it? Rose got it. Head shaking stuff from Nick Rose.
Bit of a tough second half for Nick Rose, but that is a massive stop to keep this a tie ball game.
Crowd coming alive as Shriver harnesses the ball. Shoots off the pipe. It just never fails that a seemingly innocent shot becomes dangerous quickly with Tom Shriver behind the gun.
Oh, if the ball's in his stick, there's a good chance he's got a chance to score. That's how good Tom Shriver is.
Craig up top. Shriver, piece of that by Bowl. Fresh 30. And what a battle in front as Magnin accidentally on purpose goes right back over top. And a battle on the sideboards as well. It was a Craig sandwich for a moment. He's broken free now. Vance in tight and bold stops Shriver looking for his fourth. You get all of the feels because it's a one game winner take all setting. How good would this be if it was extra games? Not the case tonight. So we know they're going to live and die in the final two and a half with every single possession, transition, run up the floor.
Illegal pick called there, and Eric Chanel doesn't love that call this late in the game, but nonetheless, Toronto going to have a chance here with just over 2 minutes to go to regain the lead.
All out battle on the floor right now. Hellier, some room, shoots! Piece of that by Bold. Thunderbirds pick it up off a favorable bounce. Taren Franco is free! Denied by Rose, rebound! Stop that too! Denied Armstrong, and Rose is all kinds of pumped up! Rose with his best and his cape on. With under two to go. And stopped by Bolt. These two played to overtime. Maybe not ironically, the finish was 14-13 that night. It was a marathon overtime. Not saying that is going to be the case yet, but what a treat it has been in Hamilton. Peterson not free. Rose is gonna have to take this one. What do they have for us before the curtain comes out? . 20 on the shot clock, 48 on the game clock. Hellier to Dawson. Craig now. Time to shoot. Craig's gonna have to let it go. It does. That one will find the seats. 28 seconds possibly separating one of these teams from the next round. Tonight's save of the game presented by Alterna Savings. Don't have to go that far back to get it, Pat.
And I'm glad we get another look at it because it was unbelievable. Makes the initial save, then makes another. We'll see Tarasenko absolutely robbed in transition. Armstrong gets another chance, and you'll see Nick Rose with an emphatic pump. As every single person in this building were up on their feet, it was a little bit of a rough second half for Nick Rose, but it's safe to say he has settled back down. 39 saves here tonight.
Draw up this possession for me, partner.
Oof. I think what you got to do is try to free up some space here for Cody Jamison. He's going to try to be the distributor. He's also going to be able to get his hands free. And you think maybe Austin Shanks, he can swing it over to the right side and get a shot off here. But the thing with Toronto's defense, John, they're so fast. They're so strong. They can fight through almost any screen.
On their feet in Hamilton.
They're going to wait probably until there's about 10 seconds left on the clock, as there's no shot clock anymore. Empty net. Six attackers on the floor.
Halifax going all in to try and win it on the last shot. Score and they move on. Jamison, Peterson, looks, holds, shoots, stop, rebound! Rose got it! Shanks behind the back! A wild dash! And they wave it off! Not before the buzzer! And Robinson thought he was the hero! But we are gonna need overtime to find out who that's gonna be! Hard to ask for any more before the final buzzer of the fourth.
Of course, Mark Gardonio is going to check this one out. Every goal in the fourth quarter under 2 minutes is reviewed, but this one's certainly going to want to take a second look, especially considering how loud this building was. Look at this shot. Peterson takes the initial shot. Keo scoops it up. An unbelievable save by Nick Rosen. Shanks almost got another one, and then there's that shot. Garrison right away saying no goal. So we see the initial shot. Big stop there. And you got to assume time expired. We don't see where the clock was at this point. We'll see it. Regardless if this goal was to stand, even if it doesn't stand, this game has been incredible.
Well, it's a new era in Halifax. This one quickly going to become an all-time favorite playoff matchup.
Mark Gardonio on the floor, as you can see there. Now we get the look with the shot clock. Time does expire.
One goal to decide the winner in a do-or-die playoff next. Welcome back to Hamilton. Overtime upon us. John Abbott, Pat Gregoire, Ashley Docking with the Thunderbirds and Rock meeting in overtime again. This was in the regular season, and it was a familiar name, Pat, ending the game. Steph LeBlanc, no longer with the Thunderbirds, and so a new hero will emerge. Winner moves on, loser goes home. This playoff game presented by Sports Interaction on TSN. Thunderbirds start after the Withers win. Jameson over. Jameson has Keogh slicing through. Stops, doesn't shoot. Jameson plays it over. Keogh in front, popped out of his stick. Fennell picks up, lets it go, but not before the shot clock. And now it's Toronto's turn.
Huge defensive stand. Jake Withers wins the draw. But Nick Rose in this defense stands strong.
Crowd on their feet, Rock with the ball. Shriver gets it back. Shriver swings it over in tight. Hasek on the follow at Hellier covered. Shriver might get that back. Swatted at it. No. Thunderbirds move it up in overtime. Glad you're with us. Can't imagine you'd be anywhere else. Jameson. Peterson. Bushi the pick. Swinging to Shanks. Shoots. Had a good look. Couldn't find it to the left of Rose.
Certainly the look they want, just not the right execution by Shanks. Instead, now at Toronto with their second possession, their chance to win it in sudden death.
Hellier. Hellier in overtime. Shoots and missed on that far side of goal. Rocket second crack at it. What a move! Dawson scores! No! Oh, I thought that was in the back. My goodness.
No goal crease. Halifax lives to die another day.
We'll see what they can drum up at the other end. Fennell. Long range, not on target. Tip three. Rock out numbers. Rogers scores! The captain sends Toronto on to the next round as they persevere and beat Halifax in overtime. Season, the Thunderbirds don't find the last goal.
And who else but the captain, the heartbeat, the Swiss Army knife, Challen Rogers in transition. And when he gets in that tight, there's no way he's making a mistake as he punches the Toronto Rocks ticket into the Eastern Conference Finals.
Toronto had swings right through the game. Unexpected, unbelievably, the Thunderbirds had their first lead in the fourth, pushed it to OT. Incredible run by Halifax. has their season end and they fall short of what they thought was an achievable goal. That was to go all the way in the postseason. Instead, Toronto, on the back of their captain, will take a big, big breath and move on to the next round.
And you said it. Halifax has to keep their heads held high. Of course, they are disappointed with the result, but the resolve in this group to come back and even get this game into overtime, absolutely crazy. But it's the hottest team in the National Lacrosse League who's going to move on to the next round, John. And look at Nick Rose. Couldn't be more fired up.
Nick Rose fired up. Let's go to Ashley with the captain.
Thanks so much, John. Challen, that game was wild, probably closer than you wanted it to be. When you scored that goal, what kind of emotional release or relief did you feel?
You know, just, I mean, obviously, what a game by Halifax to come back and fight back. But the resiliency of this group and just always believing in each other and believing in ourselves, I mean, see that one going and see everyone running at me, just what an unbelievable feeling for this group, and hats off to Halifax.
One of the things you guys always said is you win in a ton of different ways. Maybe try not to win in this fashion when you guys move on to play your next series.
Yeah, you know, with that lead, we want to keep it, not kind of lose it there in the third and fourth. But Rosie just standing on his head with like 3 seconds left to get us to overtime, and just what a game.
Thanks so much, Challen. Congratulations.
Awesome. Thank you.
No problem. John?
Thank you, Ashley. My goodness, what a wild sequence of events tonight.
The NLL on TSN is brought to you in part by Alterna Savings. Alterna offers easy, more personal financial services and puts the good in banking. Visit alterna.ca to learn more. By fanatics.ca, the NLL's home for officially licensed everything. Visit fanatics.ca today. And by Guaranteed Rate. If you believe it, you can do it. Guaranteed Rate. Believe you will.
Well, it is official now, Pat. The Toronto Rock have moved on. They will play the winner of Buffalo Albany. That yet to come. And we certainly know that the Rock are going to exhale now with the victory behind them. Should mention as well that Calgary and Colorado on TSN.ca right now. So that battle's on the West Coast just beginning. But what a finish in Hamilton tonight.
I know the word instant classic gets thrown around, but that's exactly what we saw here in Hamilton. An unbelievable effort from both teams. But it's the hottest team in the NLL continuing their quest for the NLL Cup.
That is exactly what you wanted if you are a playoff lacrosse fan. This game had a little bit of everything, and yet we couldn't have expected the way it all played out at the end. A 14-13 final for the Rock sends them on, and a last-ditch effort by Halifax was not enough. Their season is over. Unbelievable finish in Hamilton. Thanks for being with us for our first taste of this season's postseason NLL playoff action on TSN.